Hello everyone, I'm back, and in this video I'm going to do some more tests for the barriers or dams for the 100% resin geodes. I have 5 tests. The 2 above are on the left, hot glue on a silicon mat, on the right a silco body also on a silicon mat, and that's a 2 component compound, and you need to mix that together, and then you can create some dams. On the left 100% tube silicon, and I did it in a little bit of water with Dawn dish soap, and then on a plastic sheet. In the middle 100% tube silicon, and also on plastic, but then I mixed it with cornstarch. And on the right 100% tube silicon on an acetate sheet. So we already know that if we do the 100% tube silicon on a silicon mat, that it doesn't work for me, because I want to have the barriers from my silicon mat. And we already know that it sticks on a mat, so that test I don't have to do anymore. But I had some great suggestions from a lot of people, so I picked a few from them, and I'm gonna test it in this video. So I'm going to put some resin in it, and yeah, I'm very curious how the resin will come out. And I already see that the plastic is wrinkling a little bit. So I don't know how that looks when I take the resin out of it, but we will see. So now I need to wait for 12 hours, and then we can see how the resin will come out of the molds. So we are 12 hours later, and now I'm going to take the resin out of the molds, and I'm very curious. I'm starting with 100% tube silicon on an acetate sheet. That's a plastic sheet, a little bit thicker than normal, and it's also heat resistant. So I can take it out very easy, and it looks very nice, shiny. Also, the edges are okay, nothing sticks on it, but now I want the silicon to come off my acetate sheet, so that I can use the sheet again. So you can see I can peel it off. It looks okay. The next one is the 100% tube silicon that I mixed with cornstarch and put it on some plastic. What I already saw is that the plastic wrinkled underneath. So if I should do this again, then I take some thicker plastic. I can peel it off, but so you can see, the sides are not that shiny. So I don't like that. And also leaked a little bit. The wrinkling you can prevent the next time by taking some thicker plastic. But yeah, I also want the sides to be shiny. The third one is also 100% tube silicon that I mixed in some water and Dawn dish soap. Because then it's not that sticky anymore, and you can make your barriers or dams a little bit higher than when you put it out of the tube direct on the plastic. So also wrinkles on this resin, so we can prevent that with a thicker plastic, but it comes out very easy. And then the next one the silco body on a silicon mat, the two component mixture. Comes out very easy, looks very good. And I can peel the silco body off my silicon mat. But yeah, you can't use this silco body anymore because it's in one shape. You can't knead it again. You can't make another shape of it. And you can clean the silicon mat, so that's a plus. And then the last one is hot glue on a silicon mat. Comes off very easy. But I already saw that it leaked under the glue. And what I also find is that you need a lot of glue to make a nice dam. And so you can see I can't take it out because it leaked. So that isn't good. So I look at it again. And I like the first one. Because I could clean the acetate sheet. And also the resin looks very good. The second one I don't like so much because the sides are not shiny. And the third one is also okay. But the next time I need to use a thicker plastic. The fourth one, a little bit pricey. I don't use that anymore. And the fifth one, also it leaked. So I'm very positive about the first and the third one. So thank you for watching and I will see you next time. Bye.